Stocks in Asia struggled for direction on Tuesday with talk stateside failing to produce a deal on raising America's debt ceiling. Investors in the region are also keeping a close eye on private surveys on Japan's factory activity. Flash estimates from the Ojibun banks show Tokyo's manufacturing sector expanded for the first time in 7 months or since October 2022. Taking a look now at major stock indices in the region, Japan's Nikkei 225 snapped its 7-day winning streak to close in negative territory. The Hang Seng, meanwhile, is up 0.4%, even as Hong Kong's inflation saw a slight increase to 2.1% in April. Also reacting to the latest inflation figures is the Straits Times, after Singapore's April CPI came in at a higher than expected 5.7%. Over in Europe, futures point to a lower open, with investors also awaiting results from the U.S. debt ceiling negotiations. Checking now on Wall Street, major indices right there, seeing modest gains in pre-market open. Trading resumes tonight, Manila time. The U.S. voices concern on China's move to restrict sales of chipmaker Micron's products in the country. The State Department says Beijing's move was contrary to its claim it is open for business. U.S. commerce officials are now also engaging with China to discuss the ban. Beijing's cyberspace regulator barred the sales of the chip giant to domestic industries, citing risks to national security. The White House has reportedly asked South Korea to urge its chip makers not to fill any market gap in China. But policymakers in Seoul say they will not intervene and would instead leave that decision to companies. Micron's shares on NASDAQ have since dropped by nearly 3% amid news of the restriction. The National Power Corporation seeking another 10 billion pesos in loans from the land bank to keep power plants in off-grid areas running. The loan will be used to ensure small power utility group plants have enough diesel to provide electricity in remote areas. NAPO Corp President Fernando Rojas said they have already applied for the Monetary Board's approval for the loan. This is the company's second loan this year. In January, NAPO Corp requested a 5 billion peso loan from Land Bank to sustain the operations of its small plants, which are mostly diesel-powered. It has pledged to lessen its dependence on fossil fuels and shift to renewable technologies. SM Prime lists over 30 billion pesos in retail bonds at the Philippine Dealing and Exchange Corporation, or PDEX. This is the fifth tranche of SM Prime's 100 billion pesos worth of debt securities under shelf registration. Now, the fixed rate bond series were offered last May 8 to 12, with interest rates of 6.2 to 6.3%. Now, SM Prime's Chief Finance Officer John Naipeng Ong says the success of this latest fixed-rate bonds will give the company further capabilities to pursue its expansion programs. More corporate stories. Manny Villar-led companies reporting a positive showing in the first quarter. The retailer All Home returns to profitability with a net income of 212 million pesos. That is against the chain's net loss of 27.9 million pesos in the same period last year. Its quarterly revenues also up to 2.92 billion pesos. The supermarket chain Alday, meanwhile, delivers 2.4 billion pesos in top line for the first quarter. Its net income climbed to 89 million pesos from a net loss of 76 million. Revenues also grew to 2.44 billion pesos from last year's 2.29 billion. Alday Chairman Manny Villar says they are committed to reaching more Filipinos through their services. Finally, Filinvest Land enters into a joint venture agreement with KMC Community. Now, Filinvest says the deal is for the development of co-working spaces in the country. The 100 million peso joint venture will be under a 70-30% subscription between Filinvest Land and KMC. The Gutian-led company says the co-working space industry is rapidly growing amid increased demand from the rise of remote work during the pandemic.